from Harrow, number 9, Bailey Prince. A 5'8 guard in the second year from Windsor, number 10, Ian Marie Lois. A 6'3 forward in her second year from St. Edward, France. Number 11, Jessica Clemenceau. And a 5'8 guard in the fifth year from Hamilton, number 21, Heather Angus.
Hello and welcome to Live OUA Basketball on the Streaming Sports Network. Afternoon doubleheader here between the Windsor Lancers and the Guelph Gryphons. We get it started off, of course, with the women. And we'll get you the starting lineups right away, starting with the visiting number 2 ranked in the CIS Windsor Lancers. At forward, number 11 and the leading scorer in the OUA, Jessica Clemenson. Number 5, Bojana Kovacevic. Number 10, Mia Maria Langlois. Number 9, Raylan Prince. And rounding out the starting 5 for the Lancers, number 21, Heather Angus. And for the hometown University of Guelph Gryphons, just locked up, a playoff spot last weekend in their win over the McMaster Marauders. In the backcourt for the Gryphons, number 6, Alex Yallen. Number 22, Chelsea Kane. Up front for Guelph as they go with a 3-forward lineup. Number 8, Kara Mulhausen. Number 21, Jasmine Douglas. And number 11, Samantha Russell. As we get set to tip things off here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center, my name's Justin Dunk, bringing you the broadcast solo today. Both teams have locked up their places in the OUA playoffs. So it's just a case here today of rounding into form, heading into playoffs, which will take place, of course, next week, with this being the last game of the OUA's regular season, as Yallen quickly fires up a long three. That's off, rebounded by the Lancers. On the wing, that's Angus. Back up top, Prince tried to dump it down low. Foul call on the Gryphons. Foul comes against the Gryphons, number 11, Samantha Russell, her first foul, team first foul of the first quarter. Just underway here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center. No score as of yet. Windsor with the ball in the corner. That's Angus back up top. Back into the corner to Angus. She'll fire three. That's short, rebounded by the Lancers. Clemican had it in her hand for a second. Couldn't keep control of it. Out of bounds off the Lancers, Guelph Gryphon basketball. Yallen to inbounds for Guelph against this Lancer full court pressure. Mulhausen on the wing, looking to drive into the paint. Kicks it back out to Jasmine Douglas. She's up strong from 8 feet. Shots off, rebounded by the Lancers. That's Angus. Outlet pass to Langlois. On the wing, that's Prince. Taken away, poked away by Mulhausen. Chelsea Kane looking to run the fast break. All the way to the rack. Pump fake, layup up, no good off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Kovacevic. Quickly up court by the Lancers. Down in the corner, back out on the wing. Up top, swung to the elbow. Great ball movement early on by the Lancers. Wide open three in the corner. Angus on the way, that's short. Great job by Douglas and Russell to box out. Easy rebound for the Gryphons. Kane over the timeline. On the wing, that's Mulhausen looking to get a step. She does, all the way into the paint. Up strong. Ball's knocked away, but a foul call on the play, and Kara Mulhausen will head to the line to try to put up the first points in this basketball game. 0-0 tie so far. 8:21 left to go in the first quarter as Kara Mulhausen steps to the line to shoot two free throws.
Kara Mulhausen,
Mulhausen's first free throw rattles home. Griffiths out to an early 1-0 lead. Mulhausen second on the way. Up and good. Once again, rattles at home. Mulhausen knocks down both free throws as the Gryphon drop back into a three-quarter court press. Clemenceau up. Easy layup. Textbook job of breaking the Gryphon pressure by the Lancers. Resulted in easy layup for the OUA's leading scorer, averaging 19 points per game. Number 11 for the Lancers, Jessica Clemenceau. Steal. into the ball game. Morgan Jean, she heads up for the layup, picked the pocket of Mulhausen and took it end to end to convert the layup. 4-2 Lancers, up by two early on. Kane up top for Guelph on the wing. That's Mulhausen. Back up top to Yowen. 10 on the shot clock. Kane on the wing looking for a screen from Douglas. Gets cut off. Mulhausen with a step to the rim. Layup up. Rattles out. Strong move by Mulhausen to get to the rim. Just couldn't convert. On the wing. To the bucket. Langlois a little bit out of control, but she stepped out of bounds before she got the pass off. Turnover, Guelph basketball. Kane will move it up court for the Gryphons. On the wing to Yowen. Tried to get it down low to Mulhausen, but it was tipped away by the Lancers out of bounds. Gryphons maintain possession, 12 seconds on the shot clock. Yowen up top to Kane, back in the corner to Yowen. Dumped down low to Russell, had it knocked away by the Lancers. As Guelph turns it over, the Lancers quickly back the other way. Foul call on the play against the Gryphons. Foul went against Guelph's number 6, Alex Yowen, her first of the basketball game. Guelph's team second of the first quarter. On the wing, that's Prince, Kovacevic for three. She drills it. Gryphons left her wide open on the wing. She didn't make a mistake with that wide open shot. Layup up, missed by the Gryphons, rebounded by the Lancers. Prince quickly up court. That's Kovacevic on the wing. Skip pass down in the corner to Jean. Good ball movement by the Lancers. Another open three. Jean shot. Too strong. Tapped around. Mulhausen up with the loose ball. Chelsea Kane sees Russell. Nobody back on defense. Russell all the way to the rack. Layup won't go, but she's fouled on the way up. And she'll head to the free throw line to shoot two. Good job by Chelsea Kane with the court vision to see Samantha Russell streaking down the left side of the floor, wide open. No Lancer back there. Russell had a wide open lane. She was cut off and fouled by the Lancer defender, and that's why she's at the line to shoot two. Russell, first free throw on the way. Up and good. Russell knocks down the first of two free throws. As the Gryphons cut the lead to four, Lancers 7, Gryphons 3. Russell's second free throw is good. She knocks down both. The Lancer lead is now 3-7-4. Windsor with the ball over the timeline. That's Jean. On the wing, Kovacevic. Back up top, Langlois. Pumped to three, got a screen, kicked it back out. Kovacevic, another three, her second of the quarter, her second in the last three offensive possessions for Windsor. As she's starting to heat up here for the Lancers. On the wing, that's Mulhausen. Lancers lead this one, 10-4, 5:35 left to go in the first quarter. Kane on the wing for Guelph, 5 seconds on the shot clock, over to Mulhausen. Mulhausen into the paint, spin move to the rack. She's fouled on the way up. Shot no good, but Mulhausen will shoot two. Good job by Mulhausen to get into the paint, find the open area in the paint, and get to the rim and get herself a trip to the free throw line. As Kovacevic picks up her second foul here early on in this basketball game, that's a nice sight if you're a Guelph fan. Kovacevic has already knocked down two big three balls for the Lancers. But she has two quick fouls in this basketball game. Be nice to see her take a seat on the bench. Mulhausen knocked down the first free throw. Second one on the way. Nothing but net. And indeed, Kovacevic will head out. And into the game, for the Lancers. Number 6, Carissa Williams. Kovacevic getting a talking to from Windsor head coach Chantel Vallée. Wondering why she picked up that foul in their second of the basketball game so quickly as Zakowski picks off that pass. Back the other way on the fast break to the rim. Had the ball poked away out of her hands. by the Lancer defender, number 14, Morgan Jean. Guelph maintains possession as Marley Freeman checks into the game for the Gryphons. Out goes Kara Mulhausen, who's played solid here for Guelph early on. Kane to inbound on the baseline, 21 seconds on the shot clock. Zakowski in the corner. Down to Samantha Russell. Into the paint, flip hook up, no good. Rebounded by Douglas, couldn't corral it though. Off her hands, out of bounds, turnover, Lancer basketball. Langlois over the timeline. Around a screen, 15-foot jumper on the way is pure for the Lancers as they increase their lead, 12-6. Windsor up by 6. Freeman on the wing to Russell. Try to get it down low to Zakowski. A little mismatch there. Zakowski taller, much taller, at least 6 inches, and Morgan Jean. They were trying to post up Zakowski down on the block. And immediately Chantal Vallée sees that and checks Morgan Jean out of the ball game and into the game. The bigger number 21, Heather Angus, for the Lancers to match up against Zakowski. Kane on the wing for Guelph, 10 on the shot clock. Out to Russell, trying to post Zakowski again against Angus. 3 on the shot clock. Zakowski had to force it up, just hit rim. First shot was blocked, second one just touched the rim, and Douglas grabbed the offensive rebound. Griffin resets, Zakowski, long three ball on the way! Nothing but net. So Zakowski had to force the shot up to beat the 24-second shot clock, but Douglas alertly grabbed the offensive rebound. Griffins quickly reset, and Zakowski knocks down a big three. Windsor 12, Guelph 9. Lancers lead by 3, 4:10 left to go in the first quarter. Entry pass tipped away by Douglas. Great job by Douglas being active in the block and not just conceding position to Clemacone. Freeman on the wing. Back out to Russell. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Screen from Douglas. Freeman trying to get to the rim. Does layup up off the glass. Doesn't draw iron. Rebounded by the Lancers. Up court. That's Langlois. Over the timeline. On the wing. To Williams. Dump down low to Clemacone. Smooth move in the paint. She dribbled around Douglas. Got position. Put up the baby left hook. Got it to roll in off the backboard and in. And she'll head to the line to shoot one more to try to convert the old-fashioned, the old-time three-point play. Clemacone's free throw is good. Lancers lead by 6, 15-9. Zakowski over the timeline for Guelph. Zakowski all the way into the paint to the rim. Blocked from behind by Clemacone. Great job by Clemacone to recover. And block Zakowski from behind. Clemacone trips with the basketball. Has it taken away by Russell. Good job by Russell to stay alert. Griffins try to run the break, but they'll pull it back out. Yallen up top. Pump fake to 3. Into the paint. Kicked it out to Freeman. Wide open 3 on the way. That's good. Big shot by Marley Freeman. She hasn't shot it particularly well from three-point range this season, but nonetheless, she's able to knock down that shot and cut the Lancer lead to 3. Up top, that's Angus for the Lancers. Around the screen, kicks it back out. Pekulova with a long jumper on the way, back rim and out, rebounded by the Lancers. Dump back down, Clemacone, dribble drive to the rim. She gets it to go easy. Shot make off the glass for Clemacone, the leading scorer in the OUA. Kane on the wing to Freeman, just knocked down a big three for Guelph. The Windsor still leads it by 5, 17-12. Freeman around a Russell screen, 5 on the shot clock. Tried to dump it down to Russell, pass was out of her reach. Lancers easily pick off that pass. Williams tried to get it down low to Clemacone. Kick ball by Chelsea Kane of the Gryphons. Lancers maintain possession with 18 seconds on the shot clock, checking into the game for the Gryphons, number 21, Jasmine Douglas, and into the game for the Lancers, number 9, Raylan Prince. Angus up top to Langlois. On the wing, that's Williams. Thought about the three. Langlois. Dribble drive. Carried it. Yep, travel call indeed. Tried to pick the ball up and over the defender. Easy carry call for the official. Turnover, Guelph basketball. Griffins down 5, 17-12. Lancers with a bit of full court pressure. Freeman with it for Guelph. She'll get a screen from Douglas at center court. Douglas likes using those screens at center court when those guards aren't looking. Kane off a Douglas screen into the paint. Floater no good. Too soft. Off the front rim. Rebound grabbed by Windsor. Quickly up court. Williams on the wing. Up top. Clemacone. Hands it off for Langlois. Back to Clemacone in the post. She's so smooth. Step through move. Oh, man. Was that a nice move in the paint? Got Douglas, a defender, moving the other way. Stepped through and easily converted. The four-foot jumper. Lancers up 7, 19-12. Douglas now on the elbow, trying to get to the rim. She does. Shot up. Layup no good. Clemacone got a piece of it, but she also got a piece of Jasmine Douglas, and Douglas will head to the line to shoot two for the Griffins. Into the game for the Griffins, number 8, Kara Mulhausen. Checking out for Guelph, number 5, Marley Freeman, as Douglas gets ready to shoot her first free throw. Douglas knocks down the first, second one on the way. Griffins down by 6. Windsor 19, Guelph 13 here with 1:05 left to go in the first quarter. On the campus of the University. Nothing but net as Douglas knocks down both free throws. 19-14, Lancers up by 5. Williams on the wing. Gets a screen from Peklova. Williams around another screen. Another carry call though against Williams. Just hesitated a little bit with the basketball and was forced into that carry. Turnover, Lancers. Guelph takes possession with a chance to cut it to a one-possession lead. Yallen on the wing. To Zakowski. She'll fire a step-back three. That's good. Nothing but net. Zakowski with a beautiful step-back three. She's 2 for 2 today beyond the arc. 19-17. Lancers lead by 2 now. Langlois up top, waving her teammate out of the way. Screen. Three ball on the way. It's short. Rebounded by Zakowski. The Griffins will hold for the last shot. 20 seconds left to go in the first quarter. No, they won't. Langlois steals it away from Zakowski. Hands it off to Williams. To the rack. Layup's off. Ball knocked around. Picked up by the Lancers. That layup attempt is off. Knocked around again. Ball finds its way to Clemacone. She easily converts. Off the loose ball. 1 second left. Yallen tries to fire it up. It's partially blocked as the first quarter comes to an end. Griffins had a chance with the basketball to tie this game up or take the lead, but a steal by number 10, Mary Langlois, at the end of the quarter led to a Lancer basket, and that's the reason Windsor's up by 4, 21-17. Lancers lead it after one quarter. Solid quarter for the Guelph Griffins on offense, but they just haven't been able to find an answer in the post for the OUA's leading scorer. Sixth leading scorer overall in the CIS, number 11, Jessica Clemencombe. I hope I'm saying her name right. Trying my best at least, but she has 11 points, a game-high 11 points to lead the way in the first quarter, and Guelph really just hasn't had an answer for her. They've tried Samantha Russell on her in the post. She went to work on her, and then at the end of the quarter, they stuck Jasmine Douglas on her in the low block, and she went to work on Douglas as well. It's a tough matchup. She's a big... that's talented. She can step through. She's quick. But yet she still has a better reach and is taller than any of the Griffin bigs that are guarding her. It's a tough, tough matchup for the Griffins. And it's one they're going to have to get improve upon, in this game if they hope to have any chance of winning it. Clemacone just made it look so textbook in the post here early on. She's a big reason why the Lancers have a 4-point lead. Offensively for Guelph, you can't really complain. 17 points. Had a few opportunities to make some layups that you'd like to see go down. But nonetheless, Guelph with 17 points in the first quarter against the number 2 ranked team in the country. Not too shabby whatsoever. They just need to step it up on the defensive end. Let's see if they can do that here in the second quarter as the Gryphons break from the bench. It's Yallen and Zukowski in the backcourt, along with Chelsea Kane, a three-guard lineup to start the second quarter. Douglas and Mulhausen up front on the floor for the Lancers. Langlois and Jean in the backcourt up front. It's Prince, Kovacevic, and Peklova. This Lancer lineup, especially up front, is so lean and so long and athletic. It's really a tough matchup for the Guelph defense. Up top, Peklova looking to get a step on the elbow. 15-footer on the way, way too strong. Off glass, rebounded by Yallen. Mulhausen on the wing against the smaller Jean into the paint. She put her shoulder down just a hair, but Jean did a good job to set her feet and draw the offensive foul. Mulhausen knew where she wanted to get to, trying to get to the rim. Just dipped that shoulder a little bit and caused the offensive foul. Lancer basketball, Jean over the midcourt line. Jean on the wing. That's Kovacevic. She hit two big threes in the first quarter, but also has two fouls so far in this basketball game. On the wing, Langlois. Screen from Peklova. Langlois kicked it out. Kovacevic for three. That time it's short. Zukowski grabs a defensive rebound. Yallen on the wing for Guelph. Back up top to Chelsea Kane. Swung around to Mulhausen. Douglas at the elbow. 15-footer on the way. Too strong. Douglas went after it. Ball still loose on the deck. Bodies hit the floor. Douglas ties it up for Guelph. And Guelph will maintain possession as the arrow points the way of the Guelph Gryphons. Back into the game for the Windsor Lancers, number 11, Jessica Clemencon. So dangerous on the offensive end, but she's so good on the defensive end. Doesn't fall for ball fakes, holds her ground, plays it straight up. We saw it with two or three blocks already in that first quarter. Was indeed two blocks in that first quarter for Clemencon. She's just so solid at both ends of the floor. As the Lancers pick up a foul, Morgan Jean, her second foul of the basketball game. Alex Yallen will head to the free throw line to shoot two for the Gryphons. First free throw on the way. Up, rolls around, down and in and out. No good. Second free throw coming for Alex Yallen. Yallen doesn't miss too many, an 89% free throw shooter. But she misses both, surprisingly. And Douglas alertly saw that Clemencon was going to try to bank it off or step back and grab the loose ball, and Guelph will get yet another possession on offense. Mulhausen on the wing. Kicks it out. Yallen. Pump fake the three back in the corner. Mulhausen, 16-footer on the way. That's short. Tipped around by Douglas. Saved by the Lancers. Quickly up court to Clemencon. Kovacevic on the wing. Down low. Clemencon. That's got to be an offensive foul. And it is. Good job by Kara Mulhausen to set her feet. Clemencon just knocked her right over. Easy call for the official. And Guelph once again with possession. A chance to cut it to a one possession lead for the Gryphons right now as they're down 4, 21-17. Lancers lead by 4. Gryphons have done a good job so far of breaking the Lancer pressure. Again, in the corner, Mulhausen, 16-footer. This time it's good. Mulhausen cuts the Lancer lead to 2. Up top, Langlois. Bounce pass on the wing to Jean. Hand off back to Langlois. Pass intercepted by Mulhausen. Another turnover forced by the Gryphon defense. It's really come alive here early in this second quarter. On the wing, Mulhausen. Gets a screen from Zukowski. She goes baseline to the rack. Pump fake, gets a defender in the air. Goes up strong, and she's fouled. Nice move by Mulhausen, had the defender on her back, didn't just go straight up, pump faked it, got the defender in the air to draw the contact, and Mulhausen will head to the line to shoot two. The Windsor Lancers will take a timeout and give credit to the Guelph Gryphon defense here in this second quarter. The Lancers have yet to score a point. And the Gryphons have been able to cut the lead to just 2 points with Mulhausen at the free throw line with a chance to tie this ball game up at 21 apiece. During the timeout, we'll get you quickly to some first quarter stats. First, we'll start with the visiting Windsor Lancers. We talked about it. Their leading scorer in that first quarter, Jessica Clemencon, with 11. Kovacevic had 6 off 2 threes. She knocked down both of her shots in that first quarter. Langlois had 2 for the Lancers. Jean had 2 as well. Lancers shot 56% from the field. You know, that's not far off their season average. They're one of the better teams in the OUA and the CIS in terms of field goal percentage. Third, particularly in the CIS, in team field goal percentage at 44.9%. From a Guelph Gryphon perspective, you need to do a better job of changing shots and closing out on the talented Lancer shooters. Now for the hometown Guelph Gryphons in that first quarter, their leading scorer, Ali Zakowski, with 6, Kara Mulhausen with 4, Marley Freeman with 3. Gryphons only shooting 23% in that first quarter, able to knock down 3 of 4 from beyond the arc. But the key, Guelph went 8 of 8 from the free throw line in that first quarter compared to the Lancers 1 of 1. Guelph getting to the free throw line, that's really been a key factor in this team being right in this basketball game as Mulhausen knocks down another free throw. Guelph 9 of 9 so far in this basketball game from the free throw line, and the Lancer lead is now only 1. Mulhausen can't get the second free throw to go as the Lancers grab the defensive rebound into the front court. That's Langlois on the wing to Williams. Up top, Peklova, entry pass to Klimacone. She's double, kicked it back out. Kovacevic, big three on the way. That's short, rebounded by the Gryphons. Kane across the timeline. Better defensive possession there for Guelph. Look like that double team might be the answer for Klimacone. On the wing to Zakowski, 10 on the shot clock. Back up top, Mulhausen swung to Kane. Kane into the lane, nice slip pass to Zakowski, and she converts the layup. And the Gryphons take the first lead since early on in this basketball game. Guelph 22, Lancers 21. Langlois on the wing, Kovacevic. Back over to Langlois. Down low to Clemencon. Again, the double comes, but Douglas committed the foul before it could get there. Lancers will maintain possession. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Lancers will reset on offense. Douglas picks up her second foul of the basketball game. 6:46 left to go in the second quarter. Inbounds pass comes up top. Langlois on the wing. Kovacevic wide open. Long three rattles in and out. Rebound grabbed by Williams. Nobody boxed her out as she easily puts it back in the bucket. Easy offensive rebound, an easy put back for Carissa Williams as the Lancers jump back in front by 1, 23-22. Mulhausen to Kane on the wing. Gryphons looking to post Sikowski in the block. Swung back over. Douglas, step back jump from behind. Peklova didn't like the call, but it's a foul on Peklova, and Douglas was shooting, so she will indeed head to the line to shoot two as Marley Freeman and Samantha Russell check into the basketball game for Guelph. Out for the Gryphons, number 22, Chelsea Kane, and number 7, Ali Zakowski. Douglas at the line, first of 2 free throws on the way. Douglas knocks down the first free throw. Ties this ball game up, 23 apiece. Chance to put the Gryphons in the lead by 1. Second free throw on the way. Douglas's second free throw is too strong. Rebounded by the Lancers. Quickly up court. Kovacevic on the wing. Swung around to Williams. In the corner, Langlois. To Peklova, she'll rise and fire. That's a 3, rattles in and out, rebounded by Kovacevic. Douglas thought she had a block. It looked pretty clean from our broadcast vantage point, but nonetheless foul against Jasmine Douglas. That's her third personal of the basketball game, and quickly up off the bench, Allie Zakowski. She will check in for Jasmine Douglas, who picks up her third foul here just over midway through the second quarter at the WF Mitchell Athletic Center as Kovacevic knocks down the first of two free throws. Thanks for tuning in live on the Streaming Sports Network as the number two CIS-ranked Windsor Lancers battle the Guelph Gryphons. Both teams have locked up playoff seeds. Just a matter of who's going to be hot and who's going to have a win heading into the OUA West Division playoffs as Kovacevic knocks down the second free throw. Lancers lead by two. Kovacevic comes up with a steal. Easy layup in transition, and Kovacevic converts. All of a sudden, Kovacevic into double digits with 10 points on the afternoon so far. Freeman up top gets a screen from Mulhausen. Back up top to Mulhausen. Skip pass to Yowell in the corner. Intercepted by Williams. Another steal by the Lancers. Quickly up court, Kovacevic. She'll pull it back out. Peklova up top. Back out to Williams. Peklova posts. Down low. Turns baseline. Pass almost intercepted by Yowell as she knocked it out of bounds. Lancers will maintain possession, but just 4 seconds left to go on the shot clock, and the Guelph Gryphons will call timeout. And talk about how they want to play defense in the last 4 seconds remaining on the shot clock for the Windsor Lancers. Guelph right in this basketball game, give them credit. Only down by four, as Windsor leads 27-23. The last time these two teams met, it wasn't pretty from the get-go. Guelph lost 83-50, a 33-point drubbing the Lancers put on the Gryphons down in Windsor. But it's been a different story here today, as Guelph's battled this team so far through this basketball game, only down 4 points. The biggest and toughest thing to do against this Lancer basketball team is guard their length. They're so tall and long and athletic, and the Gryphons really just don't have the length and height to match up with the Lancers. But they've been gritty so far and grinding it out and forcing some possessions off some double teams in the post. Specifically some double teams against the OUA's leading scorer, Jessica Clemencon. Intercepting some passes, and the defense has really kept the Gryphons in the game in the second quarter. They've only allowed the Lancers to score 6 points halfway through the second quarter after giving up 21 in the first frame. Kovacevic to inbound for the Lancers. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Up top, Williams. Three to shoot. Langwall will force it up from 17 feet in and out. Knocked around. Russell tried to save it, but she stepped out of bounds. And the Lancers will maintain possession on offense as Chelsea Kane jumps up off the bench quickly to check in for number 8, Kara Mulhausen, as Mulhausen pulls up a little gimpy and she's getting looked at by the Gryphon trainer. Kovacevic to inbound for the Lancers. Fresh 24 for Windsor. On the wing, that's Williams. Down low to Clemencon. Back on the wing, Langlois. Guelph drops back into a 2-3 zone. They had a lot of good things happen for them last week on defense when they drop back into a 2-3 zone against the Marauders. Let's see if it can work for them here. Peklova up top. Entry pass picked off by Zakowski. But Zakowski double dribbled. She doesn't like the call, but nonetheless, turnover. Gryphons, Lancers will take over possession. Peklova in the corner to Langlois on the wing, looking for a screen from Clemencon. Langlois trying to get to the rim. She gets all the way there. Layup up, no good. But she's fouled on the way up, and Langlois will head to the line to shoot two free throws for Windsor to try to extend their 4-point lead. Langlois knocks down the first free throw. The second-year guard, an 81% free throw shooter. This whole Lancer team or a bunch of them anyways, over 80% on the season as Langlois knocks down the second free throw. Lancers lead by 6, 29-23. Freeman on the wing. Threw it back up top, way out of the reach of any Griffin, easily picked off by Langlois. She's quickly into the front court. Skip pass, Kovacevic, fake to 3, back up top to Langlois. Down low, nobody on Peklova. As they blew a defensive rotation there, Peklova easily laid it into the hoop for 2. Lancers lead now by 9. Guelph desperately needs to get something going on the offensive end. Kane up top. Kick pass Freeman, 3 ball on the way, too strong. Rebounded by Langlois. Over the timeline for the Lancers, quickly up court. Kovacevic to the rim. Layup not strong enough off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Guelph, pass intercepted by Williams. Gets it over to Kovacevic. She misses a layup. Fortunately for the Gryphons, and Freeman finally grabs a defensive rebound for Guelph. Kane up top for Guelph. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Yallen, 3 for 3. That's blocked. That length, once again, coming into play for the Lancers on defense as they get yet another block in this basketball game. Langlois over to Kovacevic. She passes up along 2. Peklova pumped the 3 down in the post to Clemencon. She takes one bounce, puts a shot up hard, but Russell there playing her straight up. Forced the miss from Clemencon. Clemencon once again in the post against a smaller Zukowski, but Zukowski gets a piece of it. But the Lancers grab the offensive rebound. Clemencon in the post again, knocked away by Zukowski. Clemencon wants a call, but nonetheless, Guelph forces a turnover. Kane to the front court, running the fast break, hands it off to Russell. She's blocked from behind by Clemencon. Makes it look so easy, but the Lancers throw the ball away. Yallen on the wing, pumps a 3. 15-footer on the way is good. Quite a sequence of plays for the Gryphons, but they get a much-needed bucket on offense to cut the Lancer lead to 6. Langlois, 14-footer on the way, but she's fouled on the way up, and she'll head to the line to shoot 2. Marley Freeman picks up the foul for the Gryphons. She's getting a talking to from head coach Tom O'Brien. And the Guelph Gryphons will call a timeout as Freeman and O'Brien still having words about the foul. Gryphons still in this basketball game, only down 6. They were doing a better job early on in the second quarter on defense, but a couple blown defensive rotations and defensive assignments led to some easy Lancer baskets, and all of a sudden, the Lancers have 10 points here in this second quarter and lead by 6, 31-25. Both teams, as I alluded to earlier in the broadcast, have locked up playoff spots. The Lancers sit with the number one overall seed in the OUA, the number one seed in the OUA Western Division, a 19-2 record. 2 games up on the second place Western Mustangs. They sit 17-3, so Windsor has locked up that first overall seed in the OUA West and in the OUA. And the Gryphons last weekend, as I talked about earlier, were able to lock up the final playoff spot in the OUA West as the Guelph sits 6th place in the OUA West Division with a 9-12 record. Of course, this being the last game of the regular season for both teams. I'm sure both teams would like to head into playoffs with the win and playing some solid basketball. And it's been a good game here early on as the Lancers lead by 8 as Langlois knocks down both free throws. Kane, pass out of the reach of Sarah Dinsdale. Dinsdale didn't do a particularly good job of anticipating that pass. Sloppy turnover by the Gryphons as Kara Mulhausen's quickly off the bench to check in for Sarah Dinsdale. Dinsdale only into the game for that one possession, and she turned it over, and head coach Tom O'Brien gave her the hook. Up top, entry pass, Clement Cohn. Strong dribble. She takes it right up and easily converts. She's so good at that move and getting deep low post position and converting down low off the glass. As Clement Cohn has 13 here with 1:35 left to go in the second or first half of this basketball game. Up top, Kane. Pass easily intercepted by Kovacevic. Second time she's done that in the quarter, all the way to the rim. Layup too strong. Followed by Williams. And she gets the layup to go while being fouled. And she'll head to the line to shoot one more as the Lancers threatening to open up this basketball game. Lancers lead by 12 now. 37-25. Williams at the line to try to convert the three-point play. Williams does knock down the free throw. Lancers' lead grows to 13. Windsor 38, Guelph 25. Guelph needs a little bit of an offensive surge going in to halftime to stay in this basketball game. Mulhausen down low to Russell. Russell fires up a 14-footer, too strong. Ball tapped around, controlled by the Lancers. Langlois quickly up court. Williams grabbed a tip pass down in the corner. Skip pass Kovacevic. Dumped it down to Clement Cohn. Back up top. Prince back over to Kovacevic. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Better defensive possession here by the Gryphons as Langlois forces up a 15-footer. And she sticks it right in the face of Ali Zukowski. Better defensive possession there by the Gryphons, but they'll turn it over on offense. Sloppy pass by Zukowski and Williams back the other way quickly. And all of a sudden, this Lancer lead has ballooned to 17. Zukowski kicked it out to Yalen. 20 seconds left to go in the first half. Griffin's down by 17. Russell up top into the paint. Strong move by Russell. She gets the layup to go to cut the Lancer lead to 15. Shot clock turned off. 8 seconds on the game clock. Ball knocked around. Yalen has it. Throws it back to Zukowski, and the first half buzzer is going to sound. That shot won't count by Zukowski. And the Lancers lead by 15 heading into halftime. Windsor 42, Guelph 27. Quite the run at the end of that second half by the Lancers to keep the Gryphons at arm's length heading into halftime as they lead by 15. Some sloppy turnovers as well. Guelph turned it over, a little confused with that pressure from the Lancers at the end of that second quarter. So those turnovers led to some fast break points. That's why the Lancers have been able to push this lead to 15. But the teams will take a break, and so will we. We'll be back with you just before the third quarter to get you set for the second half of this basketball game. So stay tuned and stay logged on. Hello and welcome back to live OUA women's basketball action. The first game of our OUA Western doubleheader here as the Windsor Lancers are in town to battle the Guelph Gryphons. Quickly, some first half stats before we get set for the third quarter for the visiting Windsor Lancers. Their leading scorer at halftime, of course, who else would it be? Number 11, Jessica Clemencon with 13. Bojana Kovacevic had 10 and Langwa had 8 for the Lancers, and they shot 44% from the floor. That's pretty much what they've shot all season long. Good for third best in the CIS in terms of team field goal percentage. Just 2 of 10 for the Lancers behind the arc, 8 of 8 from the free throw line. They've turned it over 10 times, but have been killing Guelph on the boards with 23 rebounds, in particular 9 at the offensive end. And for the Guelph Gryphons, their leading scorers in the first half, Ali Zakowski with 8, Kara Mohausen with 7, and Samantha Russell with 4. Guelph's turned the ball over just 11 times, only one more than the Lancers, but have only grabbed 12 rebounds, losing that rebounding battle by 11. And that's a big reason here in this basketball game that they're down by so much, 15 to start this third quarter. Guelph just has not found a way to deal with the length and athleticism of this talented, obviously talented Windsor Lancers team that's ranked second in the entire CIS. The Gryphons shot just 31%, which didn't help, but they knocked down 10 of 14 from the free throw line. That's a reason that they're even within arm's length of this Lancer team, as that long three ball is short, and Guelph rebounds quickly down court. Yallen into the paint, kicks it back out to Zakowski to Russell in the corner. She'll kick it out to Yallen, almost out of her reach, but she saves it. 10 on the shot clock. Yallen up top. She's going to have to force it up. Blocked by Angus. But Mohausen threw it off of Angus, out of bounds. And Guelph will maintain possession. Just one on the shot clock. They're going to have to inbound and get the shot up right away. Zakowski to Russell. She's going to rise and fire along three. Nothing but air. Shot clock violation against the Gryphons. Turnover. Lancer basketball with a chance to add to an already commanding 15-point lead. Windsor 42, Guelph 27. 9 minutes left to go in the third quarter as we just got underway here in the second half of this basketball game. Kovacevic on the wing. Screen from Clemencon. Clemencon has a mismatch, being guarded by Yallen. They can't get it to her. Angus cut off on the baseline. Pass stolen by Zakowski. Zakowski into the front court. She'll reset. Over to Yallen. Yallen around a screen. 14-footer on the way. Too strong. Rebounded by Kovacevic. Outlet pass to Langwa. Langwa looking to run. Angus on the wing. Up top. Prince. Down low to Clemencon. She'll pull it back out. Give a screen to her point guard. Langwa all the way to the rim. Easily converts the layup. When Langwa gets a step, man, she doesn't miss when she gets to the rack, as that pass is intercepted by the Lancers. Bad pass by Guelph. Angus dumps it to Kovacevic. Easy lane all the way to the rack. And Kovacevic converts for the Lancers. Sloppy passing once again for the Gryphons, as that turnover led to another Lancer bucket. Yallen rises and fires a three. That's short. Rebounded by Clemencon. She's tied up under the basket by Mohausen. Jump ball arrow points the way of the Guelph Gryphons. They'll maintain possession. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Guelph. Zakowski to inbound for Guelph. Kane in the paint. Back out to Mohausen. Mohausen right in against Clemencon, has that shot blocked. Another jump ball. Arrow points away the Lancers. They'll take over possession. Turnover Gryphons. Give Mohausen credit. She went right at Clemencon, but Clemencon easily knocked the ball away and forced the jump ball tie up, and the Lancers now have possession. Up by 19 now are the Lancers. Entry pass knocked away by Russell. Loose ball grabbed by Angus. Up top, Langwa. Langwa fires a three. That's blocked by Zakowski, and she grabs a loose ball but threw it to Yallen. try to get it to Chelsea Kane. Kane wasn't really looking for the basketball, and it knocked off of her arm out of bounds, and the Lancers fortunate to get another possession at the offensive end. Kovacevic to Klemenkon to Prince on the low block, trying to get to the rim. She's cut off baseline. Angus in the corner. Kicks it back out. Klemenkon on the wing. Kovacevic, three ball on the way. That's short. Tapped around and out of bounds off the Lancers. Guelph basketball into the basketball game for the Windsor Lancers. Number 8, Iva Peklova. And number 6, Carissa Williams, checks in for the Lancers. Out for Windsor goes number 21, Heather Angus. Kane up top for Guelph. On the wing, it's Yallin. As the Lancers drop back into a 2-3 zone of their own, let's see if the Gryphons can create some movement and get an open shot. Kane, baseline. Dump down pass to Mulhausen. She goes up strong, layup off. Russell grabbed it, threw it back up as the buzzer sounded. The Lancers grabbed the defensive rebound. Williams on the wing. To Kovacevic, up top. Fires a three. Short defensive rebound grabbed by Zakowski for Guelph. Running the break. Mulhausen to the rack. Step through. Jump stop move. Layup no good. Rebounded by Klemenkon. Pass intercepted by Russell. Good job by Russell to see that pass and pick it off and give Guelph another offensive possession as Yallin fires up the three, but she's fouled from behind by Kovacevic. She argues the call and she was almost teed up. You can see the ref's hand starting to move to call her for the tee, but she closed her mouth just in time to not pick up the technical foul, but nonetheless, Kovacevic picks up her third foul as she's looking for some sort of answer from her head coach, Chantel Vallée, and Kovacevic will check out with those three fouls as Yallin steps to the line for the first of three free throws. First free throw rattles in and out. Second free throw for Yallin. No good. Surprisingly today, Yallin so far, 0-4 from the free throw line. During the rest of the regular season, she shot 89%. She finally gets one to go, just 1-5 here today. As the Lancers now lead by 18. Windsor 46, Guelph 28. Klemenkon up top, back on the wing to Angus. Peklova trying to post, being fronted very well by Zakowski. Williams on the wing. Crossover drive. Williams to the rack. Reverse layup. Thrown wildly up in the air. But Williams again able to poke it out of the hand of Zakowski and force another turnover. Langwa wide open three. On the way. It's short. Tapped out. Rebounded by Alex Yallin for Guelph. Kane up court to Zakowski. Yallin on the wing. Had it knocked away, no foul call on the play. As the Lancers forced another turnover. Peklova, step back three on the way. It's short, tapped around, rebounded by Zakowski. Oh, she can't get her hands on it. Langwa picks up the loose ball. Knocked out of her hands by Yallin, and Guelph finally will take control of the basketball. Langwa fouled at center court. She fouled Zakowski hard. As Langwall will check out of the basketball game, looked like she was a little frustrated that she couldn't get control of the basketball during that last loose ball. And the Windsor Lancers will call timeout to try to regain a little bit of composure as this team, up by 18 for some reason, starting to get a little frustrated against the Gryphons. Credit the Gryphons for still hustling down 18, trying to claw and fight their way back into this basketball game. Doing anything they can to get some sort of offensive run going. As they're down 18, they're going to need it here to get themselves back in this game against the number 2 ranked team team in the CIS, the Windsor Lancers. Windsor comes in ranking first in many categories in the OUA. The Lancers first in points per game, averaging 76.5. First in free throw percentage, knocking down 77.5 of their attempts as a team. First in assists per game. You can really see it. They really do a good job of sharing the basketball and using one another to create space as a team to get open looks at the bucket. And they've done a good job so far here in this basketball game, and they're well on their way to their pace, their regular season pace of 76 points per game, with 46 already here, with 5:11 left to go in the third quarter here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center. Thanks for tuning in live on the Streaming Sports Network. Wherever you are, Justin Dunk bringing you the first of two basketball games here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center as the Windsor Lancers battle the Guelph Gryphons in women's action. Of course, the men's game coming up at 4 o'clock or 20 minutes after this game. And when we get to that game, we'll talk about it later. That's a crucial game in terms of the Gryphon men's basketball playoff hopes. But right here, right now, it's the women. They're down 18. Guelph with possession. 5 on the shot clock. Douglas tried to step through, but she traveled and she knew it. Turnover at Gryphons, yet another turnover at the offensive end, as Guelph has had a hard time getting any offensive flow going when they've had the basketball over the timeline. It's Jean on the wing to Langlois. Angus up top. Hands it off to Jean. Ball poked out of her hands, grabbed by Langlois. Back up top, that's Jean. Gets a screen into the paint, kicks it out to Langlois. Langlois cut off on the baseline, 3 seconds on the shot clock. Jean fires up a three and knocks it down. Great defensive possession by the Gryphons. They were all over them, fronting the girls in the post, playing the ball handlers tightly, almost forced a turnover, but the shot clock running down, Lancers able to knock down a three and extend this lead to 21. Not much going the way of the Guelph Gryphons here in this third quarter, as the Lancers have jumped out to their biggest lead of the basketball game, up 21, Windsor 49, Guelph 28, as they fix the shot clock here. In the gym, looks like we're all set to go. Zakowski to inbound for Guelph. Kane up top to Mulhausen on the wing. Zakowski down low, dribble drive. Layup no good, rebounded by Peklova. Jean throws a long pass way out of bounds. Lancers turn it over, Guelph basketball. Don't know what Jean saw there. She saw Williams in the corner, but there was a Guelph defender standing right beside her. Really tried to force that pass, and it turned into a turnover against the Lancers as Zakowski has it for Guelph over the timeline. Bounce pass to Kane, another sloppy pass. We've seen Zakowski turn it over a number of times on her own today. She has 3 on her own, almost another one there over midcourt as Douglas goes up strong and gets it to go through the contact of Iva Peklova. She brings the crowd to this feet and tries to get her team back in this basketball game. Douglas converts a layup, and she'll head to the free throw line to shoot one more. Guelph down 19. Douglas with a chance to cut it to 18. Douglas, her free throw was too strong, rebounded by Peklova. Outlet pass to Jean, up court. That's Williams on the wing. Windsor into their offense now. Angus into the paint, looking to get to the rim. Had the ball ripped right out of her hands. And a foul call will come against the Lancers as they try to take it back out of the hands of Douglas, but Douglas held on tight as Heather Angus picks up her first foul of the basketball game for the Windsor Lancers. That's already the Lancers' fourth team foul of the third quarter. Zakowski with it for Guelph. Mulhausen picks up her dribble as she's doubled, trying to hand it off to Kane, but she's tangled up. They'll call it travel. Looked like a foul call. Nonetheless, Guelph turns it over.
Seven for Windsor, number 12,
And a sub in for Windsor, number 12, Jocelyn LaRocque, as she sports that mask. Getting it buckled up, ready to go for the Lancers. The first time we've seen LaRocque into this basketball game this afternoon. Jean on the wing, bumped by Freeman. Freeman doesn't like the call, but nonetheless, Freeman will pick up her third foul of the basketball game. Guelph's team first of the quarter. As Yellen will check in quickly for Freeman. And Freeman will sit down with three fouls. Jean inbounds it to Peklova. Pump fake shot blocked by Douglas. Angus in the post. Loses control of it. Grabbed, loose ball that is, grabbed by Douglas. Kane over the timeline for Guelph. To Zukowski on the wing against Peklova. Gets a screen from Douglas. Dumps it down low to Mulhausen. She kicks it back out. Zukowski, rise and fire. That's a three ball. She banks it home. Not the way Zukowski drew it up, and she's able to get the three ball to go off the glass, but nonetheless, it still counts. And the Gryphons cut the Windsor lead to 16. Strong move. Langlois to the basket. She converts through the contact and stares down Kara Mulhausen in the process. Langlois, with a strong take to the bucket. She converts the basket, so counted for two. And Langlois will head to the line to try to convert the three-point play as Jessica Clemencon, the OUA's leading scorer, checks back into the basketball game for Windsor. Samantha Russell also into the basketball game for Guelph. Out goes number 21, Jasmine Douglas. Langlois' free throw is good. Another sub into the game for the Lancers, number 5, Bojana Kovacevic. So the Lancer lead is now 19. They really blew this game open down the stretch of the second quarter. Heading into halftime with a 15-point lead. It's grown to 19 here now in the third quarter with 2:25 left to go in the third frame. In the corner to Yellen. 10 on the shot clock for Guelph. Up top, Kane. Back out to Yellen. Better ball movement by the Gryphons. Yellen goes baseline. Kicks it out to Kane. She'll fire it up. Long two on the way. Didn't draw iron. Shot clock violation. Russell was there for the offensive rebound, but it didn't touch rim, so the shot clock didn't reset. Shot clock violation against Guelph. Windsor basketball. Jean over the timeline for the Lancers to Kovacevic off a down screen. Back up top to Jean. Down low to Clemencon. She's so deadly in the post. Kicks it out. Wide open three ball on the way for LaRocque. She splashes it home. Nothing but net for LaRocque. She knocks down her first points of this basketball game. Windsor now leads by 22. Lancers 55, Gryphons 33. Mulhausen up top for Guelph. Kane on the wing, three ball on the way. She gets it to go, rolls it home. As she answers the LaRocque three ball with one of her own to cut the Lancer lead to 19. Kovacevic gets a screen from Peklova. Step back into the corner again. LaRocque wide open for three. That shot is off, rebounded by Peklova. Fresh 24 for the Lancers. Peklova tried to feed LaRocque. Pass was too high over her head. Turnover against Windsor Guelph basketball and into the game for the Windsor Lancers. Number 15, Jessica Gordon. Out goes number 8, Iva Peklova, after committing the turnover for Windsor. Russell to Dizikowski on the wing. Mulhausen, baseline. Kick out pass to Yellen. 12-footer on the way, rattles around and down. Yellen knocks down the 12-foot jumper to cut the Lancer lead to 17. Less than a minute left to go in the third quarter. Clemencon on the block, into the paint, spins, fires, and converts off glass. Clemencon now has 15 on the day for Windsor as she increases the Lancer lead. Back to 19, Mulhausen in the paint, around Gordon to the rack, layup no good, tapped around, And Gordon will grab the loose ball for Windsor. LaRocque traveled, shuffled that foot, and the ref didn't miss it. Turnover Lancers, Guelph basketball, 21 seconds left. Chance to hold for the last shot of the quarter for the Gryphons. Kane up top for Guelph, down low, Mulhausen all alone. Blown defensive rotation by the Lancers, and Mulhausen converts the layup. Lancers lead by 17, 5 seconds left on the game clock. 3 seconds left. John trying to force a shot up. She won't get one up. Wanted a foul, no call on the play. 0.2 seconds left on the clock. Not enough time to get a shot off as Chelsea Kane holds it, and the buzzer sounds to end the third quarter of play here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center, with the Lancers leading by 17, Windsor 57, Guelph 40, heading into the fourth and final frame. Both teams, as I alluded to earlier in the broadcast, have locked up playoff positions. Windsor in first place in the OUA West, Guelph in sixth place, with the playoffs on deck next week. So both teams just looking to play some good basketball and be on a winning streak, or a little bit of winning momentum heading into the playoffs. The Lancers are currently on a big winning streak of their own. They've only lost two games all season. They've ripped off 12 wins in a row, looking for their 13th here, and it's looking good for them as they're up by 17. The Gryphons have been up and down all season, and they only have one win over a team with a 500 record, that coming all the way back at the start of the second half of the season in Guelph. The Gryphons were able to defeat the Laurentian Voyageurs, the Lakehead Thunderwolves, in the first home game of the second half of the regular season. And that's been it for Guelph as far as beating teams with a 500 record or better. They beat the teams they're supposed to beat, if you will. The teams with worse records in Guelph, all the teams in the Eastern Division that have sub 500 records, and of course the teams below them in the Western Division. But when it comes to playing with teams with the winning record, the Gryphons have had a lot of close losses, for whatever that's worth. But they've had particular trouble with the Windsor Lancers as they dropped the first meeting in the regular season down in Windsor, 83-50, a 33-point loss. And it looks like they're headed for a loss here unless they can knock down a bunch of shots here in this fourth quarter, as the Gryphons are down by 17, playing a little bit better today against the Lancers. But still not the way I'm sure head coach Tom O'Brien would like to see, as Kane has it to start the fourth quarter for Guelph. Yallen, long three ball on the way. It's short. Nothing but air. She'll turn it over. Lancers will take possession. Uncharacteristic shot for Yallen there. Really wasn't open. Just forced it up from long range, almost from 20 plus feet. Drew nothing but air, an easy job for the Lancers to get the ball back on offense. Clement Conn, double comes, kicks it out. LaRocque, faked the three, but she didn't travel. They're going to call three in the key on Clement Conn as the Lancers turn it over. Two turnovers on both teams' first offensive possessions of the fourth quarter. Kane on the wing to Yallen. Down in the corner to Russell. Zakowski, 13-footer on the way, too strong. Rebounded by Kovacevic. Jean over the timeline for Windsor. Down low to Clement Conn. She's so tough down there. Double comes, but she fights through it, and she's fouled. And Clement Conn gets herself a trip to the free throw line to shoot two to try to add to her game-high point total of 15. Clement Conn, first free throw on the way. The 85% free throw shooter knocks down the first. Second free throw coming for Clement Conn. Clement Conn meshes two free throws. She now has a game high 17 points and pushes the Lancer lead back to 19. Kane with it for Guelph. Up top on the wing, back in the corner to Russell. Down low, Mulhausen couldn't corral the pass. Intercepted by Kovacevic, quickly up court. That's Gene for Windsor. Clemencon down low, pass out of the reach of the talented scoring forward, and turn as the Lancers turn it over. Guelph basketball. Kane with it now for Guelph. Coming over the timeline to Russell. Back to Kane. On the wing to Yallin. Yallin to Mulhausen. Back out to Kane. Over to Yallin on the wing. Looking to get free. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Yallin to the rim. Forced up the layup. Shot was no good, but she's fouled on the way up, and Yallin did a good job. Shot clock winding down. She didn't force up a three. She got to the rim, forced a foul, and now Yallin will shoot the first of two free throws. Yallin meshes the first. She's been uncharacteristically bad from the free throw line today. That free throw makes her just 2 of 6 on the afternoon with her second free throw on the way. That's off. Yallin just 2 of 7 today from the free throw line as Russell knocks it off Gordon, and Guelph maintains possession. Fresh 24 for the Gryphons. Three subs into the game for the Windsor Lancers. Number 10, Langlois. Number 13, Amber Irvine. And number 6, Carissa Williams up off the bench for the Lancers. Yallin on the wing, up top to Kane. Swung around Zukowski, long three on the way. Rolls in and out, offensive rebound grabbed by Russell. Right back up with it, put back no good, too strong. Defensive rebound grabbed by the Lancers, number 13. Irvine, Williams on the wing. Up top to Gordon. In the corner, that's Irvine for Windsor. Gordon has it again up top, dumps it down. Clemencon, ball knocked out of her hands, 5 on the shot clock. Clemencon, ball knocked around on the floor. Windsor won't get a shot off. Good defensive possession there by Guelph. They force a shot clock violation. And into the game for the Windsor Lancers, Eva Peklova. Solid defensive stand there for Guelph. They force the shot clock violation. Now they have the ball on offense, down 18. Kane, step back jumper on the way, that's good. Kane knocks down a 16-footer to cut the Lancer lead to 16. Peklova up top, down low, Clemencon. She's got a one-on-one matchup, she goes to work, layup no good, rebounded by Zukowski. That's the first time, or it seems like anyway, the first time that Clemencon's had a one-on-one matchup and been unable to convert down low. Good job by Russell to play her straight up and force Clemencon to take a tough shot. And the Gryphons are rewarded as they now have possession of the basketball. 4 seconds ran off there as the ball was knocked around and out of bounds by the Lancers. So the Gryphons only have 4 seconds to get over the timeline. Mulhausen with it. Alertly ahead to Kane. Kane looking to attack. Russell in the paint, looking to get to the rim. She does. Shots way off. Loose ball grabbed by Mulhausen. 10 on the shot clock for Guelph. Kane up top. Zukowski on the wing. Gets to the rim. Shot blocked from behind by Langlois, and she grabs the loose ball and heads back the other way. Langlois behind the back dribble. Williams in the corner. Looking to get to the rim. Baseline wide open. Nobody cut her off, but she couldn't keep control of the basketball. Looked like it went out of bounds off her knee. Turnover Lancers. Guelph basketball is Jasmine Douglas quickly up off the bench for Guelph. She'll check into the game for number 11, Samantha Russell. And a sub into the game for the Windsor Lancers. Number 5, Bojana Kovacevic. She checks back in for the Lancers. Zukowski to inbound for Guelph. To Yallin, back to Zukowski. Griffin's looking to put together back-to-back offensive buckets here and get a run going to try to cut into this Lancer lead. Yallin, another long three ball on the way. Bad shot selection there from the guard, who normally is does a better job of that as Clemicon quickly back the other way, puts up the layup, no good, but she's fouled. And she will head to the line to shoot two. Clemicon so smooth down on the block for the Lancers. Quickly, we'll get you some after three-quarter stats, starting with the Lancers. Their leading scorers on the day, Clemicon 15, Kovacevic 12, Langlois 13. Some solid contributions from those Lancers. They've turned it over 19 times, surprisingly. Grabbed 33 rebounds, just killing Guelph on the boards. Lancers shot 40% in that third quarter as Samantha Russell checks into the game for the Gryphons for number 7, Ali Zakowski. Clemencon goes 1 of 2 from the line. And the Lancers have a 17-point lead. We'll get you the Guelph Gryphons stats after three quarters at the next break. Kane on the wing to Yalen. Back up top to Kane, looking to solve this 2-3 zone defense. Douglas, shot up, rolls around off the rim, rebounded by Peklova, outlet pass to Langlois. On the wing to Williams, looking to attack. Peklova swings it around Kovacevic. She'll fire up a three, never afraid to shoot, but rattles in and out. Yalen grabs the defensive rebound for Guelph. Mulhausen wide open. She'll pass up the three to shoot to two. Looked like she could have took it all the way to the rim. Pass up that opportunity. Two-point jumper, no good. Rebound, Lancers. Clemencon on the elbow. Hands it off to Kovacevic to the rim. Layup, good. Over Douglas as she was coming over for the block, but Kovacevic easily lays it home. Mulhausen back to Kane up top. Lancers lead by 19. Douglas wide open down low. She converts again through the contact. Peklova fouled Douglas down low, and Douglas will head to the line to shoot a free throw to try to convert the three-point play. Lancers lead by 17. Chance for Douglas to cut it to 16. First and only free throw on the way. Too strong, back rim and out, but rebound grabbed by Russell. Flip, hook, good, rattles home, bounced three times around the rim, but it went down, and the Lancer lead is now 15. Langlois up top, down low, Clemencon just had terrific position down low, easily took the pass and laid it home. Clemencon now with 20, a game high that is, in this basketball game so far, less than 5 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. Lancers lead by 17. Douglas picks up the loose ball, goes up strong, converts the layup for Guelph to cut the lead to 15. Douglas with 9 now on the afternoon. Kovacevic on the wing up top. Clemencon down low to Peklova. Heads position, double comes. She'll kick it back out to Langlois. Williams wide open three for Windsor, nothing but net. Whenever those Lancers get an open three, more times than not, they knock it down, and Williams did there nothing but let to push the Lancer lead back to 18. Pass tipped, intercepted by the Lancers. Williams quickly back the other way. Williams all the way to the rack, layup up and good. Lancers quickly back to a 20-point lead. Every time the Gryphons put something, a little bit of something together on the offensive end, the Lancers are right there. And once again, Guelph turns the ball over. Kovacevic, Langlois. Back to Kovacevic. She kisses it home off the glass as the Guelph Gryphons will call a timeout. This game getting out of hand here, coming down the stretch. 3:48 left to go in the fourth quarter. Guelph down by 22. Windsor 71. Guelph 49. The Gryphons were putting a little run together, had cut the deficit to 15, but the Lancers came back, forced three turnovers on defense, and quickly converted on the offensive end on their fast break opportunities to push their lead back to 22. And with only 3:48 on the clock, it doesn't look like the last home game for Alex Yalen is going to be a victory. But nonetheless, the Gryphons have clinched a playoff spot. They know they haven't played their last game of this 2010-2011 OUA season. It looks like they're likely headed for a matchup in the first round against either Brock or Laurier, or could even be Lakehead, depending how the standings shake out. Remember, Guelph already has beat Lakehead once so far this season, as the team split the season series. Lakehead 1-1, Guelph 1-1. But nonetheless, I am sure that his head coach Tom O'Brien would like to see his team play some good basketball here down the stretch of this fourth quarter, no matter what the score is. I'm sure he'd like to see his team run some solidly executed sets on offense and play some better defense. They've really given up too many easy baskets, both in the half court and on the fast break, to this talented Windsor Lancers team. Freeman in the corner, Yallen cut off. Clemencon knocks down that pass. Again, another turnover for Guelph, their fourth in a row at the offensive end. Langlois to Irvine on the wing. Entry pass, Clemencon had it knocked out of her hands in the post. Ball rolls around, picked up by Russell. Good job by Guelph to force a turnover on defense. Russell to Douglas on the elbow in the corner. Zukowski wide open for three. She'll rise and fire, nothing but net. Zukowski cuts the Guelph lead, or the Lancer lead, to 19. Better ball movement from Guelph and better job. Crisp passes, getting the ball out of their hands quickly, moving it around, forcing the defense to move. And as I say that, Langlois quickly moves to the net and converts the layup for the Lancers to answer that Zukowski three ball. Lancers lead by 21. Zukowski in the corner, back up top to Freeman. Freeman all the way to the rim. Clemencon easily blocks her from behind. And the Lancers are again away to the races. Williams quickly, easily converts a layup for the Lancers off the fast break. Guelph's fifth turnover in their last six offensive possessions. Not a good sign for this team heading into a playoff matchup. Russell on the wing. Douglas. Shot pass down low to Douglas. Great vision by Douglas as she went up. She saw Zukowski cutting underneath wide open. Pass was right on and Zukowski converted the layup. But the Lancers still lead by 21. Windsor 75. Guelph 54. Decision definitely not in doubt here at the W.F. Mitchell Athletic Center. 1:57 left to go in the final frame, as both these teams, after this game is over, will look forward to the OUA West Division playoffs. LaRocque on the wing for Windsor. Around to Gordon screen. Kick out pass to Jean. Jean off a screen up top. Can't get free from Freeman. Into the paint. Forces up a layup. Loose ball knocked around and bounces off the hands of Morgan Jean. Out of bounds, Guelph basketball. Two subs into the game for the Gryphons now. Number 21, Jasmine Douglas. And number 22, Chelsea Kane. As both those players came in for graduating seniors, number 8, Kara Mulhausen, and number 6, Alex Yallen, both graduating for the Gryphons this season. This looks like it will be their last regular season home game, their last home game of their careers. As Douglas's shot was short, rebounded by the Lancers. Up top, that's Angus. Over to Jean. Jean gets a screen from Gordon. LaRocque has it on the wing now. 5 seconds on the shot clock. LaRocque throws up a long three. Rattles in and out. Ball knocked around. Douglas controls the rebound for Guelph. Hands it off to Zukowski. On the wing to Kane. Long two on the way. Short. Rebound grabbed by Windsor. Windsor looking to run the fast break once again. But Irvine had it knocked away and the Lancers will pull it back out. 35 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Lancers look like they're headed for their 20th win of the season as Jean fires up a three. Too long, rebounded by the Lancers. LaRocque, that 12-foot jumper won't go either. Rebounded by Guelph. Freeman, 12-footer on the way. draws nothing but air, and the Lancers grab the loose ball. 15 seconds left in this basketball game. Irvin on the wing gets a screen from Gordon. As the Lancers will just dribble this one out. 5 seconds left to go before the buzzer sounds. And there it is. This one's official. The Windsor Lancers grab their 20th win of the OUA season to cap off an impressive 20-2 regular season campaign. They look primed and ready for a run at an OUA and possibly CIS championship. The Guelph Gryphons, on the other hand, have clinched a playoff spot in 6th place in the OUA West. But nonetheless, the Gryphons will head into the postseason on a 2-game losing streak. Not the way you want to go in, but at least they're in. That's all you ask for is a chance. And sad to see the last home game for some graduating players for the Gryphons, Alex Yallen and Kara Mulhausen, end in a loss. They've had some long careers here with the Gryphons. Yallen and Mulhausen looks like they will be presented with gifts from their head coach Tom O'Brien to honor their careers.
I'd also like to ask Devil Douglas, Sam Russell, and Ali Zukowski to please join us as well. Now Captain Ali Zukowski will present a gift to Alex Yallen's mom and Jasmine Douglas. Another captain will present a gift.
Ali Zukowski will present a gift to Alex Yallen's mom, and Samantha Russell will present another gift to Kara Mulhausen's mom. Girls with big smiles on their faces, special moment. Great job by the Guelph Gryphon staff to honor these two players for their efforts here for the University of Guelph Gryphon women's basketball program. As head coach Tom O'Brien takes over the mic, but we'll wrap this one up and we'll be back with you to get you set for the crucial game of the afternoon. The Gryphon men's basketball team with a chance to clinch a playoff spot with the win over the Windsor Lancers. They beat them already once this season down in Windsor, 97-94. It was a shootout, but the Gryphons got the win. As the women's game is in the books, the Lancers win 75-54. Jessica Clemencon with a game-high 20 points for the Lancers. As she scores a point over her season average, and man, is she a tough player to defend down low in the blocks. And the Lancers walk away with their 20th win and lock up the first seed throughout the OUA playoffs. Great team the Lancers are, but the Gryphons are headed for the playoffs themselves, but we will break now and be back with you to get you set for, as I said, that huge, crucial men's basketball game. The Gryphons trying to lock up that 6th place in the OUA West will come. That game will come your way shortly after as the men will warm up, and we'll get underway for that one. We'll be back with you to preview that game and get you ready, so stay tuned and stay logged on for that crucial basketball game.